Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this series, we want to create onboarding of a fitness app in React Native. This onboarding will include 7 screens, and in it we take the desired information from the user and save it. During this short series, we first design the UI screens using Figma. Then we create the project using TypeScript and create the project structure using React Navigation 6 and custom components. We create user contact form using Formik and Yup. We make the app multilingual. We perform the data flow structure using Redux. Finally, for the UI, we write tests using Jest. Well, let's start with Figma and create a new design file. From here, we select a frame that fits the mobile phone. I have already created some background images for the screens and the sample logo here. I drag the background image of the first screen into the file. I make the file a little smaller and resize the image to the size of the screen. Well, now I use the logo that I have already prepared at the top of this screen. I also make it smaller to fit the screen. Now using this tool, I write a suitable slogan for the app under the logo. From this section, I change the text settings to make it look better. So now using this tool, I create a rectangle as a button at the bottom of the screen. From this part, I change the color of the rectangle filler. For example, using pick color, I use the orange color of the logo. And by changing this value, I round the corners of the rectangle. You can also move the shape using the arrow keys. Well, now I will create a text in the center of the button so that new users can register using this button. I will also create a text below the button for users who have already registered. Well, now I will create another frame to design the screen related to user registration. I put the related background image. And I will add a text here to inform the user for what purpose it has been transferred to this page. So now I select the line from here and use it as a text input. If the line drawing is not aligned, you can change the line drawing angle from here. I I make a copy of it and put it below as the second text input. Now I put a text as an email placeholder at the top of the line. And I take a copy of it and use it as a password placeholder in the bottom line. Here I draw a small square as a checkbox using the rectangle drawing tool and holding down the shift key. I make a copy of it and use it as a second checkbox. In front of the checkboxes, I write the text I want. And bold the part of the text that I want to be clickable. And I do the same for the second text. Now I make a copy of the previous screen button and use it in this screen. Here I need to use an icon as the password visible button. If you Google the phrase free Figma icons, you will find many icons for use in this environment. For example, I use this pack that has the icons I need. Clicking this button will open the icons in a new file in my Figma account. By selecting and copying each icon, you can paste them in the file you want. Here I use the eye icon for the password field. I also need an arrow for the back button. Now I will make a copy of this frame to design the next screen. This screen will open when user clicks on the login. First, I delete the background image and insert the image associated with this screen. The image is placed on the top layer. We need to move it to the bottom layer so that other components can be seen. Well, here I change the text. I delete the checkboxes and I change the text of the button. Now I take a copy of this text and use it as the password for getting text. In the continuation of the registration screen, we want to get other information from the user. So I copy this frame to design the next screen. First, I put the related background image. Well, here I delete the extra items. And I write the text related to this screen. In fact, in this screen, we want to get the username. Finally, we change the title of the button. Well, now we copy this frame to create the next screen. First, I put the background. In this screen, we want to get a date from the user as the start date. So I delete the text input and draw a box instead to display the selected date. Of course, we expect the user to be able to select the date by clicking on this box in a pop-up. Well, I will copy the frame to design the next screen. I put the background image. In this screen, we ask the user to select a value from the available values. So I shape the box into a picker. For the pop-up arrow, we can use the icons you saw earlier. In order for these two texts to fit together, I match their colors. Now I copy this frame to create the last screen. First, I put the background. In this screen, we want to display the information entered by the user. I remove the back button and change the text of the button. And remove the picker. I complete the text based on the user's previous choices. Suppose here the user enters Mike as his name. Well, as you can see, the design of the page is over. The users see the top screens if they want to register. And if the users log in again, we want to go directly to the last screen with the user's previous information. If we want to use these backgrounds in the project, it's better to use different sizes according to the screen size of the devices. To do this, I go to this site and in this tab, I select the 3X and iOS options. Now I drag the backgrounds into it to create different sizes of each image. And as you can see, three different sizes is created for each image. I also go to this site to reduce the size of the images, and finally the smaller size of the assets folder in the project. I drag all the images into it. And as you can see, with a reduction of almost 80% in volume, we don't see a decrease in quality. Well, now I select all the images to remove the extension that the site put at the end of them. And as you can see, the volume of all images decreased without loss of quality. Also, in Figma, you can export all the frames as an image by selecting them. So there we go, we got acquainted with how to design app screens in Figma and also how to reduce the size of images for using the project. In the next session, we will create the project structure using TypeScript in React Native. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in the next video.